everything so quickly?
I have no idea what you're talking about. What do you mean moved? Did you move something?
No, you moved into his room. You know Bendy only left for like a day or two and you've already made yourself at home.
Wait, who's
what? Oh, by the Barbara? Way. No, not Barbara, Bendy. I really like your drawing. What? The hot pink is you, right? And the baby pink is me. And the orange is Lope, right?
Yes, and who's Bendy?
Oh, haha, real funny. You know who Bendy is. Oh, wow, your room looks pretty nice.
Thanks. It's always been like this.
No, it hasn't. You always share the same room with me. Well, until I moved out because I didn't really want to be near you anymore.
What? We never shared the same room. At least not after living here.
You never lived here. What are you talking about?
Yes, I did.
Okay.
I do now.
Foxy, yeah, you do now, but you never did live here before. This was Bendy's room, and then Bendy left because he's a jerk and everything.
Who was Bendy?
Are you actually kidding me right now?
No, I don't know who that is. Can you please get out of my room?
And why are you kicking me out of your room?
Well, because you were never allowed in here in the first place. I don't go in your room. You don't go in mine.
I was always allowed. You just moved in a second ago, and I saw this cute little painting where I took out from here, and it was adorable.
You're touching my Polaroids now?
Yes. I took one of the Polaroids, and I'm keeping it.
I don't know what's wrong with you today or why you're freaking out. I don't know if you had a bad dream or something, but let me make this straight. I have been in this bedroom for like 3 years now. You can leave.
Did you hit your head or something?
No, but I think you did.
You've been here for like a minute.
What are you... Okay, fine. Where do you think I used to sleep?
Well, of course, with me and Mom. In the other house.
You and... Right. Follow me real quick.
I
don't
know.
What? Maybe you ate something weird or... No,
you're the one who's acting weird. Are you doing a prank on me? Is this a camera's prank?
No! You are the one acting weird talking about someone I don't even know. Is it one of your friends? Did one of your friends be mean to you again?
It was my ex-boyfriend!
You've never had a boyfriend.
What
now
are you
I know
talking
you're lying
about?
To me.
I was dating him for a good year.
Unless you never told me about him, I don't know who that is.
You literally spent daycare with him.
This is your stuff. I occasionally come in here and go on the computer. And this is Mom's room. I see no space for me to live.
First off, that used to be our bedroom. We used to have one bed each. And Mom used to be over here.
No, the couch has always been there.
What are you talking about? The couch has always been there. You're going crazy.
I think you're going crazy.
You're going crazy. It's Mangle.
Okay, so why do you not remember all of this?
Because this wasn't here before.
Are you serious? You were literally playing here yesterday.
No, I wasn't.
You did math homework right here.
You're a liar.
I am not a liar. Call Mom and ask her.
I will call her. Where's the phone?
Jeez, I don't know. It's somewhere.
Oh, where's... found the phone. I forgot I changed
call her,
it with
ask
Bendy.
Her.
Okay.
Who's Bendy?
He was my best friend and ex-boyfriend, and he was your friend, too, since babies.
I don't even know who that... Just call her.
Okay, I'm calling her. She's not picking up the phone.
Really?
What do you mean, really? You think I control the phone or something?
No. I have stuff to do, so, and a show to watch before I miss it, so I'm gonna go.
When do you watch shows? Every time we try to go watch movies, the remote is always lost or broken.
You're the one that breaks them.
You're a liar. You're the one who always throws the sodas on the consoles and the movie players and everything.
Okay, well, the soda thing, yeah, maybe, but I like movies. I don't know what's wrong with you.
And how can you not remember Bendy? You were always complaining about how you
if I hear that name one more time,
Bendy, I will freak out.
If Bendy's real, where's this picture?
I can find his picture. Come with me.
Right, okay.
The biggest proof is I still have the ring he gave me.
Oh, a ring. You mean a ring that you probably gave yourself and your imaginary boyfriend,
No,
right?
Because this is Mangle's ring. He carved it for me, and it says, love, Bendy.
Carved it for you.
Yes, he did, and I put it in the toilet.
see.
Wait, did you take it?
There's nothing in there.
No, you took it.
What do you mean? I didn't even know you had a ring.
The ring.
I didn't even know you had a ring.
Give me back the ring.
Stop touching me. Today has been stressful and you're not making it any better with your delusions.
You're the one lying. How can you forget about Bendy? He's been with us for so long.
You know who I remember in daycare?
Who?
I remember you. I remember Toy Freddy. I remember Slendy. I don't remember anyone named Bendy, though.
How can you? He was with us the whole time.
Now, are you sure you didn't, like, lose the ring or something?
I didn't lose the ring. The ring has always been there. I check every single day to polish it and everything.
Well, you either lost it or it never existed. And considering I have never met Bendy, I think it's the second one.
You hit your head, didn't you?
Nope.
Yes, you did. You lost your memories.
What do you even mean? You and I were talking yesterday. You were completely fine. Never heard once about Bendy.
I was crying all day yesterday.
No, you weren't.
Yes, I was.
Maybe you're the one that hit your head. Did you ever think about that? Because I'm pretty sure I said it like 4 times.
See, I always thought, you know, you would stick by me with everything. But how can you tell me that I'm the liar in this situation when you have known him almost all your life?
Because I know all of your friends, and I know for a fact you never had a boyfriend because last Valentine's Day, which was recently, by the way, you were complaining.
What are you talking about? I went on a date with him on Valentine's.
You were home with me watching movies and eating ice cream.
There's no way. You literally forgot about everything.
Honestly, I'm kind of done. Like I said, I have stuff to do, so goodbye.
Okay, we need to take you to the doctor right away. We need
to
have your
head checked
out. No, I don't
care about the doctor. What is wrong with you? If I lost my memories, I would forget you, right?
No, but I think you're trying to forget about him because he left and you guys were friends as well, that you're trying to forget about him. And it's not right to forget about people. I know he did a lot wrong to you, but he did it for a reason.
Honestly, just go home, or maybe you should see a doctor.
Are you kidding me right now? Wait.
No.
Well, let's go to the pizzeria real quick, okay? I'm sure one of the kids will know about Bendy. Hey, why are you walking away from me? Remember Bendy? He's the ink guy. He's a demon.
Ink? A demon? Now I know you're lying.
What do you mean?
Ink. Nobody can be made out of ink. They would fall apart.
That's a lie. Alice Angel was made out of ink and we were in daycare together.
Excuse, who?
You don't remember her?
No.
Are you biased against ink people?
I literally have no idea what you're talking about. Ink people, okay, this sounds like a bad dream that you've had, especially with them being demons. Are you sure that like, you just didn't have a bad dream?
This is a bad dream right now. You not remembering her friends? That's awful.
I remember all of my friends.
That's a lie. If you did, you would remember them. I know Alice Angel wasn't the nicest person, but in the beginning she was.
You have imaginary friends, don't you?
I'm not crazy.
They're imaginary friends because I've never seen them and I don't know them.
I'm not so that's crazy.
You don't have to be crazy to have imaginary friends.
They're not imaginary.
But it's okay to admit that you do.
They're not imaginary.
Then where are they?
I don't know.
Well, that's convenient.
What do you mean that's convenient? I don't know where. Stop closing the door on me.
Then stop following me and stop telling these lies. I literally don't care about this imaginary person.
They're not lies. They're not.
I don't care.
They're my friends. Even though they didn't.
Well, I don't know them. Unless you met them like 2 days ago, I have no idea who these people are.
We met them for years.
Oh my God. When are you gonna get over this?
I'm never gonna get over this. They're friends.
Oh my goodness. How many times do I have to say that I've never been friends with someone named Bendy and what was her name?
Alice.
Angelica.
Angel.
Alice Angel. I don't know who those people are.
You talked to them multiple times.
Were they strangers or something?
Like I said, we spent daycare together every single day.
You don't expect me to remember someone I met once, right?
Once? I said every single day. We met multiple occasions. We basically lived together.
I've never lived with someone made out of ink, let alone have seen someone or two people made out of ink. So please, go away.
Let's go upstairs. We have computers up there. If I Google and find proof that ink people exist, will you believe me?
Sure, if you can find a yearbook photo or anything, because, you know, we have those. Because we go to school.
It's fine. Look.
Just look for the yearbook.
I'm going online. Hold up. Google ink people send. Why am I not getting any results here? I misspelled something. Hold up, let me rephrase it.
How about you check the yearbook that we were in?
People, hold up. Nothing again.
You check the yearbook?
I'll check.
Okay. Go look.
Yearbook. Wait.
That's the wrong date. Minus one.
Minus one.
Okay. Hold on. There we are.
But where is...
That's it. That's our whole class. I remember all of those people.
No, that's wrong. They were photoshopped out.
Are you serious right now?
They were people.
Who do you think photoshopped them out?
Probably Bendy's dad. He was always the mean one here. he didn't like that Bendy loved me.
Get out of my room.
Are you kidding me right now?
I don't want to hear it. I'm done with it. If Mom was here, she'd be saying the same thing.
No, if Mom was here, she wouldn't believe me.
Oh, but you can't get a hold of her now, can you?
I don't know what she's doing right now, but she's going to come home soon, and I'm going to tell her all about it, and she's going to explain to you that they were real.
Right. And have her parents met this Bendy person?
Yes, Dad approved of them. Not them.
And they knew you guys were dating?
Yes, everyone knew, even our uncle and aunt.
And when was the last time you guys were dating? When did you guys break up?
Like a day ago.
Right, because I could have sworn that like 2 or 3 months ago I had a conversation with our parents about how we needed to get you a boyfriend.
What do you mean? I've always been dating him, except for that couple of months in between, because, you know, we broke up and then we got back together.
You literally don't even talk to boys.
I do. Well, I don't talk to guys when I was with Bendy because, you know, I'm a committed person.
You haven't even acknowledged once for ages.
That's a lie. I talked to Pyro Foxy and Netbear and...
Yes,
and...
I mean, yeah, you did talk to Pyro Foxy and Netbear. Those people exist.
How can you remember them and not Bendy?
Because Bendy doesn't exist.
He does exist.
Get out of my room.
What?
Out.
You're mental!
You're mental! You are going on and on about this imaginary person that you dated. None of us have met them.
Not imaginary!
They're not even in the yearbook, and apparently we've been going to school with them for years, so get out.
They're real. You need to get checked out. I don't know who's been messing with your head. A memory chip must have fell off.
Don't
or something.
Touch me! Stop! Please!
I can't stop.
Why?
Because they're out there. And
you fell in love in a dream. Let it go.
They're not a dream.
Yeah. Yeah, they are.
No, they're not.
Get out.
How can you say it's all a dream?
Get out or I'll leave.
Okay.
Thank you.
Forget about all the memories then. Forget about all the years we spent.
Well, I guess it doesn't matter, because apparently I've forgotten them anyway.
Yeah. Shows how much you care to begin with, huh?
Shows how delusional you are.
Not delusional. Just the only sane one here, apparently.
He never existed.
He did.
Where did he come from then, huh?
He came from a different universe.
You can come from different timelines. Clearly that's true. We know that. But different dimensions? Different universe? How would we even know? We've never tapped into that kind of stuff.
It's possible.
I've never once met someone from a different dimension.
Just because you haven't met someone from a different dimension doesn't mean it's not true.
Right. So you believe me when I say that?
What do you mean?
You said, well, if just because you've never met someone doesn't mean it's not true. So you acknowledge that I'm being honest when I say I've never met Bendy.
But you have. You're confused. You're confused, Foxy.
I need you to back off.
What do you mean back off? We need to get you help. You don't understand. If you forgot the memories, then other people must have forgotten memories, and we need to save them. I'm telling you, it's Bendy's
dad.
Maybe
this imaginary person doesn't want to be found.
What do you mean he doesn't want to be found?
Well, you said he left, right?
Yeah.
Well, what if he took all his stuff with him? And I just don't remember. Maybe I met him once or twice or something. And that's why you're freaking out.
And he will just make me remember everything, you know, torture me and have everyone not remember anything about him but me.
Have you asked anyone in the town?
I asked that animatronic kid, and I know for sure they have met because I showed her, introduced her to him.
She looked pretty confused.
I know she did, but he did exist, and I'm telling you, he really did.
If everyone else doesn't remember him and you did, why do we all need help? How are you not the one with the problem?
Maybe it is me.
Maybe it was a dream. Maybe it was just a really, really long dream.
Okay. Yeah. You're right.
Because if someone lived here, I would remember them.
Yeah. It's just a dream. Sorry to bother you about
Jeez.
All that.
Yeah, it's fine. Just don't come yelling at me like that.
Yeah, I'll talk to you later then.
Yeah, goodbye, I guess.
Hey guys, it's me, Mango, here, and I'm here with Foxy Jr.
Hi.
If you guys enjoyed this episode, please do a like, comment down below, share with your friends, and of course subscribe, and make sure you comment down below that Bendy actually exists so I can prove to her she's wrong.
Anyway, hit that notification bell because we come out with videos every single day, and go follow our Twitter, HorrorDKRP, because why not? And also, he doesn't exist. He never existed, and she needs to stop. You need help.
He does exist!
Oh my God.
Mangles
get out.
Out!
Out! Out!